All right, guys, here we are again with another Intel video. And if you thought things were going bad in the last one, hold on to that and try not to laugh too hard because, actually coming to think of it, you're better off laughing than crying at what I'm about to show you. Now, I'll remind you that a few weeks ago, I published a quick video explaining Intel's new Ice Lake notebook lineup and the downright confusing naming scheme that Intel gave these new CPUs. Absolutely ridiculous. If you are interested in going through that mess again, link is right over here. But today, Intel is taking that naming scheme and doubling down on it by announcing Comet Lake. And no, they're not desktop parts, but more thin and light notebook CPUs that directly compete against Ice Lake in many cases. Just let that sink in for a moment. Now, even though they just announced the 10th gen Ice Lake processors on the 10 nanometer node, Intel is gonna be launching more products that are still gonna be under the 10th gen family. And get this, guys, these new CPUs are gonna be using the old 14 nanometer process. I think this is probably a good time to roll the sponsor message.
What would you like?
So I'm looking for a gaming headset with a bit of everything, but not overkill.
Something that folds on your neck.
Sure.
How about the light frame without excessive clamping force?
Yes.
Comfortable ear cushions with proper internal padding.
Excellent, I will take it.
The cable and the microphone are removable.
Fine, this is the one.
Multi-platform compatibility with virtual surround sound dongle available.
Can I just take one?
And the sound quality you'll be satisfied with.
So the new Cooler Master MH751 and 752 are here to make your gaming experience.
All right, so now that we're done paying some bills, let's approach this from a more calmer perspective and explain what's going on here. Now, the new naming scheme might be absolutely downright ridiculous, and I'll get to that in a little bit, but I think I might be more excited for Comet Lake than Ice Lake. It feels like Intel might be pushing the new Ice Lake processors into a niche, and that might sound weird, but I'll get to that in just a bit. What Intel is doing here is basically using the same existing technology and creating a whole new lineup of products that are supposed to offer better performance for thin and light notebooks. So these new CPUs are gonna be replacements for previous gen Whiskey Lake and Amber Lake processors. So that means you're gonna be getting more cores, higher frequencies, and they consume about the same amount of power. So what's the difference between Comet Lake and Ice Lake? Check this out. Even though Ice Lake is based on 10 nanometers, it actually consumes more power on average, comes with less cores, and operates at much lower frequencies. Seeing a 6-core, 12-thread Comet Lake processor coming to thin and light notebooks is pretty cool. But man, the fact that a previous gen architecture is being brought in now seems like a bitter pill to swallow for Intel fans, doesn't it? But Ice Lake does come with integrated Gen 11 Iris Plus graphics in some variants, while Comet Lake will still use the old Gen 9 GPUs. Both natively support Wi-Fi 6 too. Ice Lake will also have integrated Thunderbolt 3, which is optional on Comet Lake, and significantly higher speeds as well. As for performance, yeah, it's pretty incremental over the previous gen Whiskey Lake processors, but from what we've seen, this is pretty much aligned with what Ice Lake will offer too when directly comparing 4-core, 8-thread parts. And that brings me to the real problem with this launch. The way how Intel is naming these new CPUs. And I know that I might sound like a broken record from the last video, but if you take a look at this, you'll see what I'm saying. This is just freaking ridiculous. It's like Intel needs flowcharts to explain their names now, but I'll try my best to explain it. On both processor series, the i7, i5, and i3 names will stick around. After that, Ice Lake gets a 4-digit number showing it's in the 10th gen with a 10 before two numbers that show the SKU or relative performance. In this case, it's a 65. The final two characters show what type of 10th gen graphics will be inside. So in this case, it would be G7, G4, and G1. Comet Lake, on the other hand, is where things get a bit crazy since it has a 5-digit number that sort of follows current CPUs. Instead of a 7, 8, or 9, there's 10 in front of the product number. They're even keeping the U and Y product lines, so the Comet Lake series actually makes sense. Sorta. The problem is that Comet Lake isn't being launched into a vacuum. Remember, both these CPU families will be sold at the same time and are basically targeting the same market while having very similar product names. Intel has given them identical branding. The only real difference is that some, but not all Ice Lake processors feature Intel Iris Plus graphics indication. So here's the full Comet Lake lineup, and you know what, guys? It's pretty straightforward, and there are some pretty exciting CPUs in it. but you might notice all the U-Series lower TDPs have been increased to 15 watts from Whiskey Lake's 10 watts. I'm guessing that's to compensate for the increased frequencies. But here's my problem with all of this. Comet Lake is being sold as 10 gen, but it clearly isn't, because as I mentioned earlier, these are just updated Whiskey Lake notebook CPUs with more cores, higher frequencies, and Wi-Fi 6 slapped onto them. They're still on 14 nanometer, still use Gen 9 graphics cores, they still don't have native Thunderbolt 3 support, and they're on ancient Skylake core architecture. I mean, come on. So you might be asking, well, Eber, why isn't Intel selling these as 9000U and Y series since Whiskey Lake used the 8000 series names? Wouldn't that make more sense? Look, this isn't about putting the well-being of customers like you guys first. In fact, this whole branding BS is to help Intel's partners sell as many notebooks as they can to make it look like they all have a brand new architecture. So yeah, I think we all should be pissed. Now, according to Intel, they're focused on launching workload-optimized platforms. That means they'll use whatever architecture suits a product's best-case scenario, and yes, they'll even reuse older designs like Comet Lake to make that happen. So what does that mean for Ice Lake? Well, its targeted buyers are likely the ones who want to leverage upcoming AI deep learning algorithms and increased graphics horsepower. And hey, that's Intel's story, and they're sticking to it. Meanwhile, the Comet Lake U and Y series offer higher levels of productivity and multi-threaded workloads. I guess we'll have to see how this all plays out, but I'm thinking there's still going to be a ton of overlap. I'm going to wrap this up here with a bit of very honest speculation, since I'm tired of these shenanigans and frustrated. I think I get what happened. It feels like Intel can't get enough production from their 10 nanometer process, or Ice Lake isn't performing up to their expectations. Maybe it's a combination of both. I'm sure Intel would love a top-to-bottom Ice Lake lineup instead of relaunching 14 nanometer, but that's not what's happening here. Instead, we get this weird transition where two different architectures are being marketed as 10 gen. It sucks for us since we have to make sense of it for you guys, and it sucks even more for buyers. Either way, this all feels like Intel is throwing everything that they can at the wall to see what sticks out. It's a bit of a panic, so here's what I'm gonna do. AMD? Hi there, I'm looking at you. We're all looking at you. You know, Intel's opening the door. You just gotta walk right through it and don't screw up.